हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू दी पाठशाला इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजिक्स श्री आरएलटी कॉलेज ऑफ साइंस अकोला। एंड इट्स अवर लेक्चर नंबर 4, सुपर कंडक्टिविटी पार्ट 4, इन विच विल सी द कंसेप्ट ऑफ बीसीएस थ्योरी। द बीसीएस मीन्स बार्डिन, कूपर एंड श्रीफर इज द थ्री नेम ऑफ द साइंटिस्ट। They are of superconductivity was developed in 1957 by John Baldwin, Leon and Cooper and J. Robert Schiffer, who were awarded Nobel Prize in Physics in 1972 for this work. And the Baldwin also shared the 1956 Nobel Prize for his research on semiconductor and the discovery of the transistor. The mechanism that cause superconductivity may differ from mechanism that cause superconductivity of ordinary metals. So superconductivity result from the strong coupling between conduction electron and lattice. Normal conduction in ordinary metals occur when there is a weak coupling between the valence electron and the lattice. So consider an electron moving through a lattice. As electron move through a lattice, it pull the positive ion core toward it, and so that lattice get slightly deformed and changes the charge density surrounding to it. The deformation of lattice produce region of high positive charge than would otherwise be there. So another electron while moving through this polarized region will be attracted by the more concentration. So it is the attraction is stronger than the repulsion between the electron. The electron interaction with one another through the intermediate of lattice. So the net resultant is a slightly attraction of the electron for each other. Thus, the electrons are effectively coupled together in a pair called Cooper pair. Okay. According to the BCS theory, the phenomenon of superconductivity is due to the formation of Cooper pair. This theory shows that the electron system has the lowest possible energy if the electrons are bound together in a pair. See, in this diagram, there are comparison between the normal metals and the superconductor. In the normal metal, the electron has a charge is minus E and which is randomly moving inside the conductor. When we provide the current to this conductor, then the scattered of electron produce this resistance. A current generates a voltage and hence cause dissipation. But in the superconductor, according to the BCS theory, the electrons are paired together. This Cooper pair have the charges minus 2E. So when we apply the current, provide the current, then this electron is move in the pair. So the Cooper pair carrying a super current which encounter no resistance. A super current generate no voltage and hence cause no dissipation. So that when we decrease in the temperature, the conductor become a superconductor, and when we provide the current to it, then the electron is moving in the form of pair, that called Cooper pair. So due to the interaction between the two electron through the distorted lattice, the energy of second electron decreases, resulting in the lowering of energy of the electrons. So the lowering of electron energy indicates that the force between the two electrons is attractive. This type of interaction is called electron lattice electron interaction. This interaction is strongest when the two electrons have equal and opposite momenta and spin. When there is no current exist in a superconductor, the two electrons of Cooper pair have momenta equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. So then the total momenta and the electric current become a zero. So here we see detail about the Cooper pair. A Cooper pair is the name given to the electron that are bonded together in the certain manner first described by Leon Cooper. So in normal superconductor, the attraction is due to the electron interaction. The Cooper pair state form the basis of the BCS theory of superconductivity. Formation of Cooper pair, see here, the Cooper pair are formed by an attractive force between the electrons from the exchange of phonon. The energy of phonon is usually less than 0.1 electron volt. So these are the important point here. When a metal is coated to the critical temperature, electron in the metal form a Cooper pair. So Cooper pair are electrons which exchange the phonon and become a bonded together. So bonded electron behaves like a boson. Their waveform does not obey Pauli's exclusion rules, and thus they can all occupy the same quantum state. So the BCS theory of superconductivity states that bonded photon have slightly lower energy, which prevent lattice collision and thus emanates resistance. As long as KT is less than binding energy, then a current can flow without dissipation. So here we say the binding energy means the energy of Cooper pair, the pair of electrons, is less than the energy of pair in the free state. So difference in energy of the two state in the binding energy of Cooper pair. The binding energy of the Cooper pair called energy gap EG. So it is of the order of 10 to the power minus 3 electron volt. So in terms of temperature, this range corresponds to a temperature of the order of 10 Kelvin. So the superconductivity is low temperature phenomena. To break the pair, this energy has to be supplied. The BCS theory relates the energy gap of superconductor at 0 Kelvin to its critical temperature by an expression. Energy gap at 0 Kelvin EG is equals to 3.5 K into TC. At temperature above 0 Kelvin, some Cooper pair break up, so electron become a free which acts the remaining Cooper pair and reduce the energy gap. So the finally a critical temperature TC, the energy disappear and the material no more remains superconducting. So about the TC, the pair are broken and the material has a normal electric resistance. So finally here we say as a the paired electron called Cooper pair are not scattered due to their particular property of smoothly riding over the lattice imperfection without ever exchanging energy with them. So consequently, they can maintain their coupled motion up to the certain distance called coherent length. So these are the basic behind the superconductivity. So the basic of superconductivity is a BCS theory. So thank you very much for watching this video, and in the part 5 is our last lecture, and in this part 5 we see the application of superconductor. So thank you very much for watching this video.